Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the WNBA.
Hey everyone, and welcome to the WNBA on 2K Sports. And in our matchup tonight, we'll see the Seattle Storm going up against the Phoenix Mercury. Alongside Tim Swartz and Brian Vanapatemi, I'm Blake Suniga. Thanks for joining us. Now Lloyd, outside Stewart. Bird outside. Five to shoot. That one a little long. To the middle. Here's Breland. One up, one down. 2 points for the first shot in this game.
Sets the tone with physical and focused play. Breland is her team's spark plug.
Pass to Bird. Russell. Here's Lloyd. She's guarded by Griner. A nice shot by Stewart.
When you're a 6'4 shooter like Stewart, the contest, it really doesn't affect you like smaller players.
Here's Coffey. Pass to Breland. To Rossi. Covered by Lloyd. Down low. Here's Griner. It's good, and she makes her first shot of the game.
What a physical presence down low. Griner's not afraid of anyone when she's around the basket.
Now here is Lloyd. And the bucket counts, and she's on her way to the line to try to make it a three-point play. And this is her first trip to the line tonight.
Was part of the 2018 national team, helping the team win the world championships in Spain.
Now here's Griner. Outside, digging Smith. Breland, right side. It's stolen by Howard. Pass to Bird. Back to Howard. Shot clock at six. Here's Lloyd. Not gonna go that time. Diana Taurasi with some really nice D. Here's Coffey. Some solid defense from Brianna Stewart. Seattle in the lead. And here is Bird. Back to Stewart. Fires, top of the key, and again, it's the Storm missing. Pass to Diggin Smith. Back to Breland. To Rossi. The 10-footer, and the basket is good. And it's all knotted up.
A well-developed mid-range game makes Taurasi extremely difficult to contain. She can truly score on all three levels.
Now here's Howard. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Out of bounds, it'll go to the Mercury. And here the Mercury. Side, Diggin Smith. Pass to Breland. Outside for Diggin Smith. Got a piece of it.
Way to stay alert and grab the long rebound.
Here's Howard. Basket counts.
Dropping dime. Bird has incredible vision and feel. She sees the whole court.
Pass to Taurasi. Breland, right side. The 15-footer, good.
That's what I call pretty passive. Timely recognition as to where the open teammate was.
Here's Lloyd. Now Now here is Howard. She's covered by Taurasi. And that's a foul called on Jessica Breeden. That is her first foul of the game. Outside Stewart, outside Lloyd.
Shot clock at 5.
Over Breeland. That one rolling around and rims out. Here's Coffey. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. They double team Brittany Griner.
They tie it up and it's a jump ball.
Mercury with the ball.
Skylar Diggins-Smith outside.
And no good. And the Storm going the other way now. Pass to Lloyd. She's off on that one. Diana Taurasi with some really nice D.
Poked away. And stolen by Canada.
Outside Lloyd. And here's Canada. 6 to shoot, and it's blocked by Diana Taurasi.
The stuff by Taurasi, she's a big point guard at 6 feet.
Two shots. Foul. Elbow. 2. Under the line from the Phoenix Mercury. Skylar Diggins-Smith. At the line for 2.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And the free throw is good. Now leading by 1.
With multiple WNBA All-Star Game appearances already, Diggins-Smith has really made a name for herself in this league.
Good on the second, so she makes both. Canada with it. She's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Pass to Howard.
Fades.
Mercury with the rebound.
She kind of short-armed that shot after doing a nice job of getting open.
Walker Kimbrough. Yes, and it's Rhea Hartley picking up the assist.
Have to go strong, the finger roll over the D instead.
On the wing, Sammy Whitcomb. She's guarded by Hartley. Mark outside. Right side, Canada. Let's the floater go.
Terrific job defending the basket that time. It's not an easy task stopping her when she's headed to the rim.
Here's Diggins-Smith. That's in for her first basket of the game. 3 attempts.
They're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
No luck needed. It is working for sure. 5 of their last 6 field goals, and they've come from inside the feet.
Now here's Hartley inside. A nice shot by Griner.
That's a nice bucket. They're really playing intelligently.
They really are, and even though it's not a huge lead they've got, they're definitely in charge.
Kind of get that feeling, Brian, that team is playing so well.
Seattle calls timeout.
Well, they're pretty disappointed, this coaching staff, and rightfully so. Just they're giving up a big run right now. Got to figure out a way to stop it.
Yeah, they haven't really looked good at all here lately. Something's got to change for them. Let's see what the coaching staff has up their sleeve.
Dwight Howard, outside Canada. And it's blocked by Brittany Griner.
Another block by Griner. Normally, she leads the league in blocks.
And he hits it and gets hacked. That's a three-point possibility if he can convert the free throw. And here are the Storm now. It's a 10-point game. Now here is Canada. He's guarded by Hartley. Six on the shot clock.
On the wing, Sammy Whitcomb.
Trying to get back on track. Rebounded by Walker Kimbrough.
You know, typically she has the touch to finish when she's in that tight. Not sure what happened there.
Yeah, they're allowing a sky-high field goal percentage. This just isn't going to cut it if they want a chance at winning this game.
Not at all. You rarely see a team surrender points this easily. I mean, effort-wise, execution-wise, something. They've got to do better.
Here's Turner. Pass to Walker Kimbrough. Here's Turner. She's covered by Clark. From deep. And it's Seattle with the rebound.
7 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock.
Here's Howard. To the inside. Langhorne gets the bucket.
The easy look off the pass from Howard. Great awareness leads to the bucket.
To the paint. Reiner's shot is good.
They've made one bucket after another since getting this game started. I wonder if this is the early stages of a blowout.
Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves just yet, Tim. I wouldn't go that far, but it has been pretty ugly so far.
And an overpowering first quarter effort, already a double-digit advantage. Mercury out in front. They lead by 12. And we'll bring you the... And a very convincing performance from the Mercury so far.
Well, we've seen them really get out and establish an offensive rhythm.
And they're finding ways to score, you know, playing well and getting good offense.
And here are the Mercury. The 12-point lead, their biggest of the game. Hartley with it. Howard's there. Whitcomb with the steal. Here's Canada. The putback. Great positioning on the putback.
Fourth in the league in O-boards during her breakout 2018 campaign. Howard is a threat to turn any missed shot into a bucket.
Pass to Hartley. Now Griner.
Whitcomb defending.
They double-team Brittany Griner. Walker Kimbrough. Bullseye! Nails it!
No matter who it is, that kind of D is going to cut it.
Now here's Howard. And here's Canada. Inside. And there's the whistle. Out hard on the shot, and we'll go to the line.
She's gotten so much better at getting free throws. Howard has significantly increased her trips to the line over the last few years. Learning to draw contact.
This is her first opportunity at the line this evening. And she can't get the first.
A bench player over her first 4 years in the league, Natasha Howard finally got the chance to start in 2018 with Seattle, helping the Storm to a WNBA championship.
And she's good on the second. Second quarter, and we're just over a minute in. Here's Turner. And foul called as she misses. And she's going to shoot two free throws. And
goes on Natasha Howard.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Also good, so she hits them both. And here are the Storm now. They trail by 14. Outside Whitcomb. Dark outside. Back to Whitcomb. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Stolen by Hartley. And here comes the break. It. Good.
As soon as that steal was made, there was nothing they could really do to stop the break.
And that's why turnovers will kill you. It gives your coach a headache and puts you at such a disadvantage defending.
And that's what every team wants, easy points.
Bucket is good.
She just might be the best pick and roll player in league history. Bird has handles, vision, passing ability. All of that helps her break down the D.
Poked away. So she draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good.
Shooting 100% in the quarter, they're just taking full advantage at the line.
Very nice job making the most of their opportunities.
No good on the second free throw. A difficult situation for Seattle. Outside Lloyd. Pass to Clark. Here's Stewart. Clock at 6. Bird, guarded by Griner. Russell misses.
It's very dangerous to leave her open like that. Lucky break for the D that she missed it.
Griner, no good.
Tough D on the inside.
Sure was. No easy access to the bucket when she's in the middle.
Clark can't hit. Rossi outside. The 3 is up. Russell pulls it in.
Yeah, the great shooters, they know when they've got enough opening to go for the 3. I didn't think it was a bad choice there.
Yeah, not very good defensive coverage that time. The D got lucky.
And it's out of bounds to the Mercury as Phoenix retains possession. And just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Freeland outside. Rossi outside. And again, Phoenix no good.
They had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
And when she's open like that, you don't see her miss that sort of look very often.
Pass to Clark. Outside Stewart. Shot clock at 6. And the basket by Lloyd.
Decisive. It's a quality for any good shooter. Lloyd has it. Just get the ball, fire away.
And here's Carassi, guarded by Bird. Here's the teardrop, and Carassi lays it up and in.
You knew what you wanted to do all along, the teardrop.
Bird outside, pass to Lloyd. That shot, no good. Diana Taurasi with some really nice D.
It's a +5 advantage for them in the rebounding category after that one.
Very steady work they've been doing on the interior. Really a well-rounded effort overall.
Bird outside. Pass to Stewart.
Brittany Griner with a defensive effort. Phoenix with the ball. Here's Turner. He has five. Here's Coffey.
Guarded by Russell.
Freeland outside. And there's a whistle. That's going to go on Breonna Stewart.
That is her first foul of the game.
Griner with the ball.
She's against Russell.
A nice shot by Griner.
Honestly, when she hits in this area of the court, you might as well quit. It makes Griner almost impossible to stop. She just can't leave her out there.
Time called here. The Storm decide to talk it over.
They'd seen enough scoring in the paint and wanted to send a message to their team. Lock things up inside.
Yeah, you're right, Tim. I guarantee you this talk centers around cutting down on all those points coming against them in the paint.
And maybe it's more help. It's the front of player. They've got to try something.
Canada. Wyatt so far offensively searching for her first points of the game. Just five to shoot. Three-pointer Breonna Stewart. The rebound by Brittany Griner.
With the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be. And that's firmly in the driver's seat.
Rebounding, it's an effort stack. They've been the more determined team to this point.
And yep, it's good.
You know, the D pays so much attention to Lloyd, it allows others to get open looks. One reason Lloyd is a valuable offensive talent.
To the inside. Freeland misses.
That's rough. No one to blame but herself. She should definitely have scored that time. I don't know what happened.
I tell you, plays like that really show you why Stewart is regarded as one of the most lethal scorers in the league. Tenacious.
And she's got her first opportunity at the line here tonight.
Free throw shooting, a key part of Stewart's game. She gets the line a lot. Plus, she's a career 80% foul shooter.
Griner,
guarded by Russell.
They double team Brittany Griner. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. And here are the Storm now. This gives them the opportunity to get within 10. Pass to Howard. Stewart with the ball. Freeland defending. There's Jewel Lloyd with the three. And it's Brittany Griner with the rebound.
You've got to give them credit for the job they've done on the boards.
Well, guys, they've done a lot of things well, but their rebounding is right at the top of the list.
Here's Coffey. Six to shoot. Three, Diana Taurasi. That ball is off target, and that's her third miss. She's made two shots from the field.
It's been a bit of a struggle for her this quarter in terms of scoring the ball.
Aska Lloyd. Howard. For three. And it's Stewart missing.
She got one to fall in the first quarter, but in the second quarter, simply has not been able to find her shot from downtown. She's fortunate that that shot found the bottom of the bucket.
Pass to Howard. Jessica Breland with some nice D.
Well, good defense in the paint. Worth its weight in gold.
It absolutely is, and we just saw it right there, didn't we? Without her presence, that's an easy 2 points.
Here's Taurasi, and it's Breonna Stewart.
Stewart with the rebound. Some tough offensive sets, and they really want to turn it around.
They got to lock in and need a basket just to regain some momentum. He hasn't had much success shooting the ball.
And the officials signal the backcourt violation, not being careful there.
They've been doing a lot of things right in this game, but something they have to improve on is their ball security.
You know, they've been lucky. They hold the lead despite the miscues. If they clean those up, you have to like their chances.
Outside Canada. Pass to Howard. Knocks it loose. And up the court comes the Mercury on the break. Freeland with the bucket.
Reads the defense so well. It's really what makes Diggins Smith the top-notch point guard she is.
Now here's Whitcomb, guarded by Diggins Smith. 13 feet out. He can't get it to go.
Yeah, I mean, she has been way off the mark this quarter. It is getting rough. Maybe the last player you want to try to score against. Howard is an elite defensive player. Puts in great effort every game.
And the first half now in the books. It's the Mercury up by 15. Stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter going. We're seeing a tremendous game from Brittany Griner.
Her decision making simply flawless today. Nothing but quality shots from her in the first half. She wasn't forcing anything.
Yeah, but I think here in the second half, they may want her to be a little more assertive and start taking more shots, even the tough ones.
Welcome back as we begin the second half. So far, not a tightly contested game, but anything can happen. Pass to Taurasi. Five on the clock. Here's Coffey, defended by Stewart. Here's Diana Taurasi from the arc. It's rebounded by Seattle. Lloyd with it. Howard. Pass to Lloyd. And it's rebounded by Jessica Breland.
Some of the shots she's taken today have been absolute head scratchers. She's out there playing like it's a game of horse, and it's not.
Rejected by Natasha Howard. Out of bounds, the Mercury able to retain possession here. And if you're just joining us, we've played just over a minute here in the third. Just four to shoot. A nice shot by Diggins Smith.
A part of Diggins Smith's game that she continues to work on, but a fiery competitor like her never sets limits on what they can and can't do.
Gets it to go from downtown.
Well, she can give it as good as she gets.
We're seeing some gamesmanship right now. Answers right back with a three of her own.
Foul call that time on the way up, and that'll give her 2 chances at the free throw. It's on Sue Bird.
With great balance and body control, Diggins Smith isn't easy to defend. She really makes defenders work on that end of the floor.
First one falls forward. And that one goes in, 2 from the line that time. Pass to Stewart. Howard. And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. And here's Bird outside. Bangs home the trifecta.
Top 3 all-time in threes made. Bird has an easy shot. She doesn't need lots of space either.
It's stolen by Stewart. Here's Bird. Doesn't go that time. And it's Phoenix the other way. They led by as many as 18 points. Freeland with the bucket.
A tall, physical presence. Freeland does the majority of her damage from the interior.
Pass to Lloyd. Russell. Left side, Stewart. Tries to break her ice. Another shot, and it's good on the lay-in.
What a hustle play by Stewart. Picks up the trash and puts it in the can. She has such a motor.
Rossi outside. Down low. Reiner. The basket good off the assist from Diana Taurasi.
And it's pretty hard not to notice the difference in the passing of these two teams today.
Yeah, I mean, when you look at the stats monitor, it was a stark discrepancy. When you look at the assist column, and you see that difference as far as fluidity in their respective offenses, too.
Shot clock at 2. Bird, no good.
Excellent interior D right there to force the miss.
Yeah, and unlike you, Tim, her defensive ability is a huge factor. No doubt about it.
To the wing, right side. Side Stewart. And it's Seattle scoring again.
Please, please don't take your eyes off her, because she can make plays from multiple spots on the floor.
And the Mercury call time here.
They could tell their players were dragging a bit and called time out to let them catch their breath.
Turner, 5 points in the game. Pass to Walker Kimbrough. Now Griner. 6 on the shot clock. And it's good for 2.
Some defensive breakdowns happening now. Their last 4 buckets allowed at a very close range.
And giving up these high percentage shot attempts, it's not going to get it done. They need to figure it out.
Howard. Second shot opportunity, and the layup is good.
You like to give maybe a degree of difficulty bonus there for Howard. Great concentration to put it through the hoop.
Pass to Griner. That shot off. Crystal Langhorn with the defensive effort. Here's Clark. And that one goes long. And this has been a one-sided affair.
Yeah, they've done a very nice job of extending their lead.
Here's Coffey. And she uses the glass on the layup.
She's so good at recognizing where the openings are and getting that ball to the rim.
Pass to Howard. And she was fouled on the way up. Two free throws for her.
That's where she wants the ball. Howard is such a high percentage shooter. She gets into good spots, forces fouls.
This is her second trip to the free throw line in this one.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Hits both from the stripe. And these guys have had some good motion on offense. Nice assists.
When everybody's involved offensively, it's in a way helping you defensively too.
An open look for Alicia Clark. And again, it's the Storm missing.
Plus eight in the rebound differential. One more reason they have absolutely just controlled this game.
Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative for sure.
And it started out with the rebounding. It sets a tone.
Pass to Whitcomb. Clark. And the foul called on Griner. That is her third foul so far. Inbound. Here's Clark. Turner grabs the board.
The defense was ready for her, got a hand in her face, and made that one much tougher.
And that's something that every team needs. Rugged interior defense to just make your opponent think twice about coming down the lane.
He's off on the first. Good on the second free throw. Here's Seattle. 17-point game. Clark outside. Pass to Canada. To the middle. Howard, that's good.
Despite her troubles in the first half, she stayed composed, stayed focused, and now she's getting it going.
Here's Walker Kimbrough. Whitcomb defending. Here's Turner. 5 points in the game. Shot clock at three. Here's Griner. And again, Phoenix no good. Here's Howard. Here's Walker Kimbrough. He's got six. Pass to Turner. Over Langhorn. And it's Turner missing.
That's too good a look to pass up there, despite the result.
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot, and we'll shoot two at the line.
With the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
That's some old-school defense, just telling them no easy layups, as simple as that, and I like to see it.
Shooting two.
and she makes the first. That one falls, so she hits both of them.
A perfect half at the free throw line for them. That'll help their comeback effort for sure.
Yeah, those free throws are helping them keep contact.
Hartley.
Jessica Breland, a good look.
That one is good. She has missed only one of her six shots from the floor.
Awesome mechanics. Breland anticipates how to get her feet set and rise up without hesitation.
Howard can't get it to go.
Well, you love the tough D, especially inside.
And that's exactly what she gives you, Tim. Constantly making her presence felt around the rim.
Here's Hartley. And again, it's Phoenix.
They haven't been as aggressive from outside as they were in the first. Playing smart with the lead.
Now a timeout called by Seattle.
The coach needs to get him back into a flow offensively. Things have slowed down. And they're starting kind of to force their shots.
Yeah, things have snowballed on them here. You know, the misses just started piling up. I'd like this timeout to sort of calm down the team and get reset.
Outside Canada, Stewart. Pass to Russell. Canada, she's guarded by Hartley. Just two to shoot. And the Storm miss again.
I'm sorry to say it, guys, but she's given them little to nothing at the offensive end.
Here's Walker Kimbrough. Outside. Offline with a three. And a foul on the shot. She'll go to the stripe for two. It's going to be on Jessica Breland. The first free throw is good. Third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. It's the Mercury, up by 16. Don't go anywhere. The final quarter is coming up next on 2K Sports. And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. The Storm with possession. They trail by 16. Pass to Stewart. Russell. Here's Lloyd. And he sticks that one in from 20 feet away.
The sick handles of Lloyd, it works well in the two-player game. It puts defenders into a tough spot.
Now Hartley. 6. Here's Coffey.
Some solid defense from Brianna Stewart.
Pass to Canada.
Rhea Hartley with some nice D.
Here's Walker Kimbrough. Can't hit that one. Now Seattle takes it the other way. Outside Canada. Stewart. Outside Howard. Pass to Canada. From beyond the arc. And it's Phoenix with the rebound. They led by as many as 18 points. Here's Walker Kimbrough. Guarded by Canada. Back to Hartley. Coffey. Hartley outside. They grab their own miss. Reiner, shot is good.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking that rim, Brian.
That's right. It's been all good at one end, and let's be diplomatic and just say not so good at the other.
Lloyd with the three, drills it from outside.
Her first three of the half, second of the game. Can she heat up?
And the Mercury with possession. 13-point lead. Pass to Griner. Walker Kimbrough. Here's Breland. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. That one on Lloyd.
The game seemingly comes easy to Breland, who is a skilled player and really adept at creating offense for herself and others.
And he knocks down the first one.
They've done a much better job from the line this half. They've gotten their percentage to over 80% now.
That's good as she hits both shots.
Yeah, Blake, right now they're about 85% for the game.
Pass to Bird. Now Russell. She's guarded by Hartley. And so she earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact and she'll shoot two.
Shoot two.
Sinks the second. They have a really solid lead at this point.
Definitely on the other side, really not much resistance put up.
A nice shot by Diggins Smith.
Shaky defense down low again. It's just been a mismatch in the paint.
I'm sure they didn't go into this one expecting to get battered like this inside.
Outside Lloyd.
Defenders.
Shoot two.
The first one falls. Shots good from the stripe. A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Knocked loose. Brianna Stewart with the steal. The rebound by Brittany Brown. Outside. Inside, Diggins Smith.
Pass to Taurasi.
Outside, Diggins Smith.
Some solid defense from Brianna Stewart.
To the paint.
Howard
doesn't get it to drop for her.
Jessica Breland with some nice D. Diana Taurasi on the wing.
And again, Phoenix no good.
Down low.
And that one's good. Stewart.
At 6'4", with her abilities, it's almost impossible to stop Stewart down low.
Outside, Diggins Smith. Reiner, guarded by Russell.
Reiner's shot is off.
Well, got it in close, but credit the tight defense for forcing the miss.
Defense like that ups the degree of difficulty on that shot by about what? I'd say 300%?
308% maybe.
Okay, I like that.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
She makes the first. And so she hits both.
She has made an effort here to get into the defense more and create some contact opportunities. And for the most part, she's succeeding.
Timeout called the Mercury.
Yeah, I think the coach is trying to take the wind out of their sails here. They're on the wrong end of a run and need to sort things out offensively and defensively.
Yeah, things were starting to spiral out of control on them a little bit, and a timeout was a no-brainer there. Yeah,
exactly, Brian.
Diggins Smith. Taurasi outside. Reiner. Shoots over Russell. And again, Phoenix no good. Outside Lloyd. Lets it go from 11. It's good.
You don't see too many players anymore score from this area, but Lloyd has an old school feel to her game.
Skylar Diggins-Smith penetrating, misses and close.
You know, it might be a poor shooting performance for her, but luckily her teammates have picked up the slack. She was one step ahead of the D in making that pass. Nice assist.
Count it. Number 5 from the floor this game. She's hoisted up 11 so far.
We've seen an obvious improvement out of her since halftime, and she just didn't really have a whole lot working for her in the first half.
Lloyd from long range, and the Storm, another three.
The coach has got to be yelling, and it's pretty simple. Keep getting her the ball. She's delivering here in the fourth.
She's dialed in right now. 6 for 6 in the quarter, and still looking for more.
Tipped.
Coffee. And she drops in the layup off glass.
Well, that pick, it worked like a charm. Nice job taking it right to the tin for the layup.
Bird outside. It's Jewel Lloyd with the drive. Second chance shot. And she takes it up and lays it in.
Defensively, they're on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
And if they don't start showing some aggression, things are just going to get worse.
Taurasi outside. Back to Diggins Smith. Just 5 on the clock. That's in, and she's 7 of 12 now for the game.
Sometimes you look at Brittany Griner and you think she is an unstoppable force. A little bump, it doesn't do anything to stop her. She's so locked in on scoring.
Stewart, and the layup's good off the glass.
Used to these clutch situations, national championships, gold medal games, WNBA finals. Stewart's played them all.
Diana Taurasi on the wing. From 20 feet out, bullseye! And here is Stewart. Inside. And that one goes in as she's fouled. It'll be 3 points. And she's going to convert the free throw. Diggins-Smith to the inside. Shot clock at 6. Reeland. And she makes good on the layup.
Phenomenal effort. Reeland creates scoring chances for herself by relentlessly working on the offensive glass.
Deanna Stewart drives in. Count that one.
What a big-time bucket. Stewart just loves these situations. Remember, she's a WNBA Finals MVP.
Inside. Reeland misses.
Yeah, just like me. I can't believe that layup didn't fall. I don't think she can either.
It's in! And she has brought them within 2 points.
Well, it's really almost like an automatic 2 points. Put them up on the board anytime she gets the ball that close to the basket.
The defense has to battle to keep her out of that position in the first place, or it's going to be a long day for them.
Stewart
connects. She has tied up this game. Oh, what a shot.
You think Stewart's bothered by a little contact? If so, think again. What a finish.
Now a timeout called by Phoenix.
WNBA Finals, gold medal game. You know, Sue Bird has seen it all. And these baskets are old habit for her.
Timeout called from Mercury.
separating the shot and game clocks.
Right side, Diggins. That one's off. Still out of sync. And they go to the intentional foul.
And that's just what they have to do in order to get that ball back.
Yeah, to me, that's a good foul. Clock management, crucial at this time of the game.
He drops the first one. And that makes it a three-point lead. And so he drops them both. And it's a four-point ball game.
Now that's how you close a game out. Those free throws will bury them for sure.
4-3.
No good.
Wow, it is a huge day on the glass for a player who's, you know what, they're giving up a lot of size to bigger players out there. Very impressive.
And so the big win by Seattle in a tight game.